Hello. Today I will provide a quick overview of how high-speed amplifiers, like the OPA365-Q1 from Texas Instruments, are being used in current monitoring applications to enable the next generation of hybrid and electric vehicles. I will also provide an overview of a reference design, or TI design, that features the OPA365-Q1 in a high-power motor HVAC compressor system. To see this entire TI design in detail, check out the link below. With vehicle electrification increasing, and as fully electric vehicles become more mainstream, the number of electric motors and digital power control systems in automobiles are expanding. Many of these systems require high-speed current monitoring circuits to ensure proper operation and to protect against potentially damaging overcurrent conditions. One way to accomplish this function is to use a low-side current shunt monitoring circuit like the one shown in the diagram. This circuit provides overcurrent and short circuit protection with the use of two op amps, two comparators, and a D-type flip-flop. The OPA365-Q1 op amp performs a differential voltage measurement across a shunt resistor. The voltage across the resistor corresponds to the current that flows through the inverter. The op amp used in this part of the circuit must have low noise, low offset, fast settling time, and a high slew rate in order to achieve a fast response time to detect overcurrent or short circuit conditions in the system. The OPA365-Q1 is an ideal amplifier for this application. It has 50 MHz of bandwidth, noise of only 4.5 nanovolts per root hertz, a low offset of only 100 microvolts, a fast settling time of 0.3 microseconds, and a slew rate of 25 volts per microsecond. The device also has an operating temperature range of -40 to 125 degrees Celsius and is AEC Q100 Grade 1 qualified for automotive applications. The TLV314-Q1 is used as a voltage follower and functions as a source for the reference voltage. It provides a reference voltage of VCC divided by 2 to the OPA365. With this configuration, the output voltage range of the OPA365 ranges from half of VCC to VCC for one direction of shunt current, and from half of VCC to ground for the other direction of shunt current. The output of the OPA365 is then provided to the comparator circuit and the analog-to-digital converter input of the C2000 microcontroller. The C2000 F28052 microcontroller is part of TI's Piccolo family of MCUs. It has a 12-bit 3.75 megasample per second ADC that is driven by the OPA365 amplifier and can be used to monitor or log the shunt current. Since a short circuit or overcurrent condition can be potentially harmful, a comparator-based shutoff circuit is also implemented. This comparator-based circuit can disable the gate drivers much faster than the microcontroller. The OPA365 differential op amp is followed by two LMV393-Q1 comparators, one of which is always inverted. The comparators have trigger levels that correspond to an overcurrent condition. The inverted comparator makes it possible to detect current peaks in the shunt resistor in the opposite direction. When an overcurrent or short circuit current occurs in one of the phases of the inverter, the responsible comparator detects it and changes its output state accordingly. When the comparator changes state, it triggers the D-type flip-flop to disable the buffer between the MCU and gate drivers. When the buffer is disabled, the gate driver input signals are pulled down through the low-side resistors connected to each control line, and the gate drivers force the insulated gate bipolar transistors, or IGBTs, in the system to turn off. This current monitoring circuit is featured in a TI design for a high-voltage, high-power motor drive for automotive HVAC compressors. More information about the TI design, including full design schematics, can be downloaded from the link shown below. The circuit board for the reference design is shown here. The reference design features a three-phase inverter drive, which is based on discrete IGBTs for driving brushless DC motors for automotive AC compressors using sensorless torque control. The isolated design has a low voltage side and a high voltage side. The C2000 microcontroller running the BLDC motor control algorithm is shown here on the high voltage side of the system. The current monitor circuit that features the OPA365-Q1 amplifier is on the back side of the board. For more information about TI's OPA365-Q1 amplifier and to download the device datasheet, visit the link below. To see TI's entire portfolio of amplifiers and comparators, check out ti.com/opamp. I hope that you have found this video useful. Thank you for watching.